The life of Mother Mariam Thresia was characterized by an intense personal love of God and care for the family unit. Mother Mariam Thresia was born Marth Thresia in Kerala on April the 26th, 1876. From the time of her childhood in Kerala, India, she was deeply impressed when her mother spoke about Jesus' sacrifice on the cross.
She used to ask her mother repeatedly, why did Jesus have to die for us? And she said, if he suffered so much for us, for me, I should also respond to her. So she started a life of penance, penitential life, as a child itself. And I think her whole life was kind of responding to God's love revealed in the person of Jesus on the cross.
She deeply desired to suffer as Christ had in order to be closer to him, and therefore cared for the poor, the sick, and the dying, even going against common Indian morals in order to do so. She was known to have cared for those suffering of measles and leprosy. She had a special charism for the family unit, as she was convinced that if a family unit is healthy, there will be many more happy and healthy people in the world. Mariam Thresia is a mystic of the 20th century who is largely yet to be discovered. Similar to Teresa of Avila, she had frequent ecstasies and levitations. In 1909, she received the stigmata, but along with these mystical experiences also came demonic attacks. She was not properly understood by church authorities. Mariam Thresia underwent several exorcisms. These mystical experiences became an obstacle for Mother Mariam to open the religious congregation that she desired. Finally, on May 14, 1914, with the permission of the bishop and under the guidance of her spiritual director, now Venerable Joseph Vitwatil, she founded the Congregation of the Holy Family.
After founding the congregation also, she worked for the poor people, for the families, etc. And that is what we are doing now itself. Now also, we are going to the families. Our main charism is family apostolate.
The congregation is spread throughout the world from Africa to America with over 1,500 professed sisters and 176 houses.
She had a passionate love for God and a compassionate love for the families, for the people. So we also have this charism to carry the compassionate love of God to the families, to the persons, through family apostolate.
Mother Mariam Thresia was beatified by Pope St. John Paul II in 2000.